Hello students, so today we will be studying about the chapter digestion and absorption, and first we will try to understand the basics of digestion and the organs involved in it. So let's start it. So we are talking about the process of digestion. You know that there are many processes in the body which takes place: excretion and control and coordination, breathing, respiration and transportation. So we'll start with digestion, which is a part of human physiology. So what do we understand by digestion? It is the process of conversion of food that you eat, right? Food into simple absorbable form, right, by chemical and mechanical process, right? So first we need to understand, when we are talking about human beings, what kind of system we are following. We are following nutrition system, that is holozoic. That means we are eating solid food material. Now for two, eating is fine, that means it involves ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion, right? Now if we eat the solid food material, then that means it need to process. Until the time it get processed, the reason being we're not using it, we're eating complex food material which needs to get broken down into simpler forms which can be absorbed easily by the body. So that needs to get used by the body and ingested by the body, right? So this is the system of this is the holozoic mode of nutrition. Now that's what our human body system follows. And so the process of conversion of food into simple absorbable form by chemical, that means using enzymes, by chemical process, and mechanical, that is physical, that chewing and those all arts will be included in the physical process. So this is known as digestion, right? For this we have a system known as digestive system, or in human digestive system. So we have digestive system, which is composed of alimentary canal. Now it's a tube which from ingestion to the egestion, which is connected to many organs and moves through many organs, carrying the food and doing all those processes which just now I discussed about. So this canal includes glands also associated with the glands also, which secrete the enzymes required at different stages for the digestion of different parts of the food, right? So it starts with the mouth. Inside the mouth is buccal cavity, right? In the buccal cavity, so it starts with the first thing is alimentary canal starts with the mouth, the buccal cavity or the oral cavity, inside which we have two main organs for the process: teeth and tongue. Now what happens is that the teeth, we'll talk about it later, but tongue, the thing is that tongue has small projections. Now tongue has small projections which are known as papillae, right? Now papillae has, some of the papillae contains taste buds. And these taste buds are responsible for us to actually sense the different taste of the food, right? So now this is what the role of the taste bud is. Now what is the role of the the teeth, we have different terms associated. Now we need to understand those terms. First term is thycodont. Now what do we understand by thycodont? Thycodont means when the teeth are inserted inside the socket like structure. So they are in the jaw, they are socket like structure into which the teeth are embedded. So this is known as thecodont, right? Then the other term is diphyodont. Now diphyodont is what? Two kinds of teeth. That do I'm not trying to say that we have two kinds of teeth, although we have four kinds of teeth. Diphyodont means we get teeth set two times in our life cycle. So we call them milk teeth, which are temporary, and permanent teeth, which are supposed to be permanent unless you, with because of any injury, you hurt them and the teeth gets removed from your this set. Then it cannot be it cannot come back. Milk teeth ones will be broken down and will come back, but the permanent teeth ones broken will not come back. So some people who at early age, they by mistake or because of some accident, they get the teeth gets broken, then they get their teeth replaced, or they get the artificial tooth put at that place, right? And then we have another term which I'll write here. Let me just remove this thing, this part, which is heterodont. Now heterodont is what? What is heterodont? Heterodont means the teeth are of, hetero means different, dont means teeth. That means those teeth I was talking about, four kinds of teeth. What are those four kinds of teeth? ICPM. What is ICPM? Incisor. This is incisor, canine, premolar and molar. Right? Incisor is meant to, the first two teeth. So if the formula is 2-1-2-3. 2-1-2-3 means from here, from the center, two incisors, one canine, two premolars and one three molars. Similarly, in the lower side, two incisors, one canine, two premolars and three molars. So now here what happens is that this 2-1-2-3 by 2-1-2-3 becomes 16, and same thing happens in the left side also. So in the left side, the 16 plus 16 becomes 32, and that's why we say that we have permanent set of teeth, that is 32, right? So incisor is meant to chew or bite, canine is meant to tear, and that's why we say canine is those organisms which mainly eat flesh, so they have more of canines. Then premolars and molars are meant to grind the food, because we need to grind it properly in order to make it in such a form that it gets easily worked upon by the enzymes and goes into the and gets broken down easily and come into that form of absorbable form, so that it can be absorbed easily and used by the body. So this is the terminology which will be used when we talk about buccal cavity. So then food moves to the, now buccal cavity is done, then food moves to the pharynx. Now what is pharynx? Pharynx is the starting point of the esophagus. So pharynx is the opening of the it's a common opening passage for food and air, right? And then it gets divided into larynx, where the air moves, and which is covered by the epiglottis, and then there is food, right? Food pipe, which is esophagus, right? So there is a flap which is known as, which the tube is known as glottis, right? Or windpipe, which is covered by, the glottis is covered by a flap like structure which is known as epiglottis. Epi means over, so epiglottis is a flap like structure which kind of protects the windpipe so that food doesn't enter inside it, right? Or else we can get choked. So then once the food has moved inside, then there is esophagus. So esophagus again is, I'll write down here, then we have esophagus. Esophagus is what? It's food pipe through which food moves, and food moves in a manner, in such a regulated manner because of the movement called peristaltic movement. Right, now this peristaltic movement makes sure that the regulated amount of or controlled amount of food enters into the next organ, and also to make sure that the food is moving. So these kind of, if food will get accumulated at certain place, then it will be difficult for us to do any other function or utilize it. So peristaltic movement makes sure the food is moving, and that is known as peristaltic movement. And that is not only happening in esophagus, but it's also happening in the whole alimentary canal. So food peristaltic movement is done, and then there are some portions which are having sphincter. I'll talk about it in the next portion. Now next is stomach. Now what is stomach? Stomach is a J-shaped organ which is after the food pipe. So it is something like this, right? It has four portions. So yahan pe, this side is esophagus, which has sphincter, cardiac sphincter. It makes sure that the, now sphincter is like a door which makes sure that again the regulated amount of food is entering inside the stomach, right? Now so it's also known as gastroesophageal sphincter, right? That means a sphincter which is connecting the esophagus and the gastro part of the stomach, right? So that is making sure that food once entered doesn't move back into the esophagus, and the acid which is being created in the stomach for the digestion also doesn't get back. And sometimes it does, then we call it that we are feeling like acidity. That is because the food is again moving back to the esophagus, right? Or the acid, right? So now the portions of the, what are the portions of the stomach? There are four portions: fundus, after that cardiac, then pyloric. There are four portions basically, right? Cardiac is upwards near this side. This is fundus, then this is cardiac, this portion is body, and this is the lower portion is called pyloric. And then again there is a, now when the food is worked upon in the stomach portion, then it again moves to the small intestine part and is controlled by the regulations and by pyloric sphincter. So now you know the role of sphincter to make sure that the required amount only goes to the next organ and doesn't come back, right? So then the portion with starch is known as duodenum, right? Next is small intestine. Now let's talk about small intestine. Now small intestine is the largest portion of the, it is the largest portion of the alimentary canal. That largest means longest, rather it's longest, right? And it is divided into three parts, which are, what are those three parts? The first part is duodenum, then there is jejunum, and then there is ileum, right? Duodenum, jejunum and ileum. So if we draw the diagram, so this is the tube which is entering inside the this structure, and here is the small intestine. So this part is duodenum. Now here is jejunum, and the part which is in the end is known as ileum, right, which enters into the large intestine, right? Now similarly, large intestine, now this is the portion where the absorption takes place. So it will not say this is the portion where assimilation takes place. So this is the portion where absorption takes place. That means there are the alimentary canal has some portions called finger-like projections called villi, which are basically meant to absorb the finally digested nutrients, food material in the form of nutrients, and they basically absorb them and transfer it to the underlying the capillaries, into which when the food, the nutrients enter, they move to the cells, and in the cell when they get utilized, those nutrients, that is known as assimilation, right? So it is the main, so small intestine is the main portion for the absorption, right? Now we talk about large intestine. Now large intestine is when the ileum opens into large intestine, which is divided into, let me use another thing, caecum or caecum, colon, right? So caecum, colon, and rectum, right? So this is the portion which is attaches to the ileum, takes up the material from the small intestine, moves it to the colon. Then from the colon, the food, so this is from the colon, it moves to the portion, a portion called rectum, and from rectum to the anus. Now the rectum is the portion where the unwanted fecal matter, or fecal matter basically, it's stored for the time being, and then get digested through anus, right? So caecum is also having a structure called something like this, called vermiform appendix, which is a vestigial organ. But if food gets stuck into that, then it creates a problem and can be needs to be removed through a surgery, right? Now we are done with the main organs of the alimentary canal. Now we'll talk about the alimentary canal's histology. So histology of the, now histology means the structure of the tissue, right? So if we draw the diagram of the alimentary canal, it's like this. If you take the tube like this, and if we take its transverse section, then it will be like this. So first, there are four major layers, right? So the outermost layer is serosa. Let me just first draw it for you. Right? So the outermost layer is called serosa, which is like something like this. Then this one is known as muscularis, which is composed of basically muscles for the peristaltic movement. Then this one is submucosa, which is below the supporting the mucous gland. Then this is mucosa, having the releases the mucus. And this one is the inner side is lumen, which is the empty portion through which food moves, right? So what is serosa? It is the outermost and made up of squamous epithelium. That means cells having shape like square, and plus areola, so it's stretchable and all of that. So areola, connective tissue, If you want to know more about all these, let me know in the comment section. I will reply. Then muscularis. Muscularis is made up of outer, longitudinally shaped, longitudinal muscle. Longitudinal muscle. Outer side the muscles are in the longitudinal form, and inner side they are in the circular form. Right? Arranged in a circular manner. Right? So that the movement can take place in the longitudinal manner also, and in circular manner also. Right? Then they have also network of nerve fiber, right? Then there is submucosa, which consists of loose connective tissue, of course, and has a lot of blood plus lymph capillaries. I hope you can see lymph capillaries, right? And then there is Then finally there is mucosa, which is lined by, which is the innermost one. Innermost is mucosa, right? And has many fold, as you can see, many foldings, which are known as rugae, right? RUGAE, and villi also, and they have mucus forming glands so that there is lubrication and food can move easily and doesn't get stuck at one point. There are mucus forming glands in the stomach. In different areas they have glands. Mucus forming glands in the stomach, small intestine, they have villi in the intestine, and the gap between villi is having crypts of libercle, which you will study in detail in the further class. So this is the basic structure of the four layers of the alimentary canal if we cut it in a transverse section manner. Then we'll talk about the glands. So glands, we have three glands basically. So first we'll mean four glands basically. So first we have glands, salivary gland.